Well, it's never too early for spring cleaning. A few years ago, Dave Bruno took it to the next step. He didn't just clean up his house, he cleaned out his life. Take a look.
A few years ago, there was a specific moment when we had spent some time cleaning up the house, and at the end of the day, it was a mess. And then I went to our closet, and the closet was a mess. And then I went down to the garage, that was a mess. And that's kind of when I just hit. I realized, wait a second, I need to do something about this. If you're gonna seek personal change, you need to keep it personal. That doesn't mean you can't inspire somebody else to maybe come alongside you.
Our whole family has kind of gotten into the spirit of it and have gotten rid of a lot of stuff. And it feels really good and freeing to be rid of a lot of clutter.
It took me quite a while to get down to 100 personal items. And I think it just opened up a dialogue that a lot of times doesn't exist.
Well, Dave Bruno has also written a book about his experiences. It's called The 100 Thing Challenge. Dave, welcome to the 700 Club.
Thanks
so much.
It's
great to have you here.
Great to be here.
While cleaning your house, you came up with the 100 Thing Challenge. Tell me about that.
Well, we've always tried to live fairly simply, and that's the thing. And so we spent a weekend cleaning up, and we were all done. And I went to find something in what was then my home office, and I couldn't find it because it was a mess. And then I went to my closet, and it was a mess, and the garage was a mess, and kind of just...
Oh, you're speaking to my soul here.
Yeah.
What do you mean when you say that you were a slave to your belongings?
You know, yeah, I talk about that, but actually it was Jesus talked about that in the Sermon on the Mount. He says, right, you're going to serve one of two masters. And, you know, I think I think what ends up happening is people think that our stuff just sits around. It doesn't do anything, right?
Yeah.
But in reality, a master is somebody that bosses you around, tells you what to do.
Yes.
And that's really what goes on with stuff when you put it in the wrong perspective.
In the book, you talk a lot about American consumerism.
Yeah.
And, you know, just reading about it, it really is true how we go out mm-hmm. and though our closets mm-hmm. and our attics and many of the rooms in our house are overcrowded, we just keep buying more.
Yeah.
What is that? Why do we do that?
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, by definition, consumerism is an economic system where we have to continually buy stuff in order for the system to work, right?
Yeah.
But I think in America, we've kind of taken that to another level, and we don't just buy stuff to make our economy work, but to make ourselves feel good,
mm-hmm.
to fill in holes in our lives sometimes, and it becomes part of our identity.
So how did you overcome that?
Well, you know, I think that the way to do it is simply to—I like to use this term, reduce and refuse.
Yeah.
You got to get rid of stuff and give yourself time, right,
mm-hmm.
to reevaluate what's your priorities in your life. Yeah.
Talk about the 100 Thing Challenge. You actually got stuff down to 100 things.
Yeah.
How'd you decide what to get rid of, what to keep, and how you'd regulate all of that?
Yeah, yeah. Well, a great place to start, and it's the easiest thing to know what to keep is clothes, right? We all have to have a certain amount of clothes.
But you kind of bunch them together, so we're not talking about, you know, one shirt, one...
Well, the only thing that I bunched together were socks and undershirts and undergarments, right? Everything else, though, was counted individually. So my jacket is one item, the suit pants that go with the jacket are one item, each shirt is an item, things along those lines. Yeah.
You also counted the things like, and boy, I related to this because mm-hmm. I'm a book lover.
And
I mean, my piles of books have piles
talk
about of
my books. Big cheat, right?
And you lump that together. But then when you do that, how do you make some sanity out of it?
Yeah, well, you know, I think one thing that with regards to simplifying that's important is that this is not, we're not simplifying to like live a repressed kind of lifestyle.
Right.
You know what I mean? In my case, I'm an author. I'm a big reader. You know, if you write books, you got to read books and whatnot. And it's just it's an important part of our whole family's life, right? Is reading and stuff. So we decided to keep one library, and that was the big cheat.
And so the challenge was to figure out what qualifies enough in your significance to keep in that library.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And so we definitely do downsize books and give books away and whatnot. But
what was the hardest thing you got rid of?
You know, there's a number of different things. In my book, I talk about this. The hardest thing, I think, to get rid of were my woodworking tools. And I'm not a great woodworker, but I aspired to be something that was a little bit more maybe than I am.
How'd you come to the conclusion that you weren't going to become that and that you could let go of them?
Well, you know, I think just in my case, there's a time issue. And then just kind of being honest mm-hmm. with yourself. And I think sometimes we hold on to some things and we say, you know, if I get maybe one more thing, then I'll become something that I wish I always was.
Did you have a rule of thumb that was kind of like, if I haven't used this in 6 months or a year or something, I'm going to let it go?
Yeah, you know, I didn't really do that, although I think it's a great idea. I simply got rid of almost everything that I had, you know, hundreds and hundreds of the different things. And I would say that when I got down to, most of the time I was in about the mid-90s, just about everything I used on a daily or weekly basis.
Did you make any mistakes?
You know, one thing that I got rid of that I replaced right after the 100 Thing Challenge was over was my guitar. And fortunately, I'm talking, not singing. I have a horrible singing voice, but I enjoy playing the guitar, enjoy singing in the private of my home with my girls and whatnot. And yeah, that was something that I regretted. But I will say this: a year away from the guitar, it's been great. And now we've kind of returned to it and had a lot of fun.
We should say also that this wasn't something you required of everyone in your household.
No.
You really did this for you.
Yeah.
But I hear your wife saying that. The whole family.
It has an effect. Absolutely, absolutely. And I think that that's really important. You know, when you want to do a personal change, you need to keep it personal. And if you inspire others and they take it their own way, that's a great thing too. And in our family, we've definitely downsized, and it's been a real help. In fact, I was just telling somebody, it's actually inspired us to do the Dave Ramsey, you know, Financial
Peace
University.
No kidding. So you're cleaning up your financial house,
yeah,
too.
Exactly. You know, one thing leads to another.
Yes.
And it's a real good
yes.
thing.
Yes. Well, it's all right here, the 100 Thing Challenge. And if you're sitting there going, well, I don't need that, take a look at this and just ask yourself if your stuff owns you. We all have something we're hanging on to that we don't need. More information on this, you can log on to CBN.com and check out our free fact sheet on the subject as well. Or you can pick up a copy of Dave's book. It's in stores nationwide. It's called The 100 Thing Challenge: How I Got Rid of Almost Everything, Remade My Life, and Regained My Soul. Thank you, Dave. God bless you. Great to have you here.